lasted. Everybody, please mute yourself. Everybody, please mute yourself first. Everybody's going to mute yourself. So, in the last class, we saw types of soil, that is alluvial. Please tell me which were the soils which we saw in the last class. Yes, Kirti Chogle.
Yeah, mommy.
Yes, Kirti Chogle, please tell me.
Mommy was man. Okay.
Please tell me which soils did we see? Okay, now we'll start with the laterite soil. So this soil is found in the part of Karnataka, Kerala. You must have seen when you go to the Khanapur site. Everybody, others, please mute yourself first. Everybody, others, please mute yourself. There is a lot of disturbance, children. Please mute yourself. Unless and until you mute yourself, you will not able to hear me. Everybody mute yourself. Please mute yourself. Children, please mute yourself. Okay, so when you go to Khanapur site, you will find these type of soil. In this soil, what they do, you know, this soil is helpful to make bricks. You know, this soil is... Children, please mute yourself. Who is this? Please mute yourself. Mute yourself. Anand Patil. Who is Anand Patil? Please mute yourself. Prashant Vandekar. Please mute yourself. Prashant Vandekar, please mute yourself. Prashant Vandekar, please mute yourself. Okay, so these type of soils we found in Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Telangana, Odisha, and it is formed when rainy, heavy rains wash away the minerals from the soil, children. So the humus content is very low. Whatever the soil content of humus, that is being washed away by the heavy rains. And as this Anand Patil, please mute yourself. Anand Patil, please mute yourself. It is lot of disturbance is coming. Anand Patil, mute yourself. Okay, so these type of soil is formed there, and because of the heavy rains, what happens, whatever the minerals the soil contains, that is being washed away, and the humus content in this soil is very less. So this soil is generally infertile, means you can't plant the plants over here. So one example also I'll give you. In your garden also, or in your pot, when you're planting the water to the plants, if you use pipe and all, if the water force is too much, what will happen? The first layer of the soil is being washed away. The same thing happens here also. When there are heavy rains, what happens? The topmost soil is being washed away. So this soil, whatever humus is there, that will be washed away. So this is infertile soil. So you can make this soil fertile by adding the manure to this soil. So this soil can be used to grow tea, coffee, rubber, coconut, and fruits. So this soil is also used for making bricks. As I told you, when you go to Khanapur Road, you will see these type of soils over there. So what these people do, you know, they take this soil, they make bricks from this soil. Next, we'll come to the mountain soil. Now, many of them must have seen mountains, isn't it? You must have seen mountains, how mountains, aap gaye honge wahan pe, you must have seen the mountains. So. But each and every mountain will not have the same type of soil. Why is it so? Can anybody tell me? Why is it so that the mountains do not have the same kind of soil? Yes, anybody? Can anybody tell me why is it so? So soil has been varied in every mountain because mountain soil is formed on the hills, slopes of Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh. So here these soils, these type of mountain soils you found there because in that area there are many mountains. Okay, so you must have learned in the last year also when we were doing the mountain range and all. So so here even the brown soil is there, which is rich in organic matter. Why? Because there are many trees on the mountains and also which when sometimes what happens, they die and they decay and it is rich in humus. So crops like wheat, maize, barley, tea, coffee and spices are grown in this soil. So in other parts of soil is low in humus and acidic. So there what happens, you know, they do not grow there anything because the soil is not so fertile. So some of the mountains on their own, due to the animals, birds, okay, what happens, this pollination happens and then these seeds, whatever, due to the animals, birds, wherever they go, the plants start growing on the mountains. And you can see even the grasses also growing on the mountains. So this is mountain soil. Now let's come to the desert soil. Now what is desert soil? If you go to Rajasthan and Gujarat, you'll find these type of desert soil because there is desert region is more in Rajasthan and Gujarat. It is very sandy and it is infertile. The soil is very infertile. So with proper irrigation, crops like wheat, dates, barley, maize, pulses, cotton can be grown in this soil. So I told you what is irrigation, isn't it, in the last to last class, how this happens and all. So this was desert soil. Now we will come to the soil conservation. Now we saw the types of soils, isn't it? Now how to conserve these soil? How to conserve these soils? When what happens, you know, when the top layer of the soil is being washed or blown away due to the rain, it might be due to the wind, it might be, okay. So this what will happen, the topmost soil which is fertile, what happens, it has been washed away. So this is called as soil erosion. So it can also happen due to excess of cutting the trees, because what happens, you know, if you grow more and more trees, the top soil is being catched hold by the roots. So the soil erosion is less where there are more trees. If you cut down trees continuously, what will happen? The topmost soil can be washed away by the water by the wind, and even overgrazing of the animals like cows and all. What happens, what they do, they eat all the grass, and the topmost soil is also again being washed away. So as this exposes the soil to the wind and the rain, so the topmost soil can be washed away. So we have to stop overgrazing of animals, we have to stop cutting the trees. So soil erosion removes the natural nutrients and minerals present in the soil, thus affecting in its fertility. Now if we if the topmost soil is being washed away, so the soil won't be fertile. So what we need to do, again we have to put manure, natural manures, and then again make it fertile. So if we take care of these all things, we can conserve the soil. So there are some following steps to be taken to prevent the soil erosion. So reduce cutting down the trees, plant more and more trees, that is afforestation. Then we have to stop overgrazing of the animals. Do not leave the fields barren, means we have to do the crop rotation. Due to this, what will happen, the soil erosion will be less there. So we have to keep the fields every time rotating. So we have to not keep the fields left away like that way only. Then we have to use more of natural fertilizers on manure instead of chemical fertilizer. Now anybody can tell me what might be the natural fertilizers? Yes, anyone? Natural fertilizers, who can tell me?
Cow dung.
Yes, cow dung, that is one thing. And but excess of cow dung is also not good for the plants. Do you know this? So anything else? Huh, cow dung is there. Okay, that is also one thing. Something else?
Dead plants and trees, ma'am.
Huh, what happens, you know, there is one pit. Okay, if you go to the village, you can see there is a pit. There what they do, you know, they put the cow dung also, they put the whatever dead plants, animals, whatever is there, that also is being thrown out. Then again, after this also, whatever food what we prepare is being left away, that is also being thrown into that pit. And after sometimes that manure, the natural fertilizer will be ready, and that you can put, that fertilizer can be put into the fields and to your pots also. So this is one method. Now children, here we have been completed with the soils of India. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Yes, children.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am.
Huh?
Ma'am, I didn't understand the red soil.
Okay, this I'll just show you. See, can you see the PPT over here? I'll just make it a little bit more bigger. So this type of seed, okay, this type of soil is of no use for the plants to grow, because the topmost soil is being eroded, means due to the heavy rains is being washed away the minerals from the soil. So the humus content is very less in this. Okay, so this soil is being used to make in making of bricks. If you go to Khanapur, once more I'll tell you, whenever you visit Khanapur, you go na, that time you see this type of soil you will find over there. And with the help of this soil, they prepare bricks. Which bricks, you know, which we use for the construction of the buildings. Okay, and if you want to make this soil fertile also, we have to use some manure to this soil. We have to add some manure to the soil, and then here you can in this type of soil you can grow tea, coffee, rubber, coconut and fruits. So this is, if you have any doubts, you can ask me once more, Jayal.
Yes, you, ma'am.
Is it Kriti Chowdhury?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Can you explain soil erosion again?
Yes, yes, I will definitely. Children, what is soil erosion? I'll tell you. What happens, you know, the topmost soil, if there are no plants on that soil or nothing, if just there is a soil, what happens, you know, when there are heavy rains, when the wind is when the wind blows very strongly, what happens? The topmost layer of the soil, what happens? It is being washed away by the heavy rains or by the wind. Again, it is being washed away. So, if the topmost layer is being washed away, the soil is not fertile. So, this is called as soil erosion. So, if you want to prevent this, if you want to prevent the soil erosion, you need to reduce cutting of trees. If in that same case, on the soil, if there are many trees, what will happen? The roots of the trees go inside and they hold the soil very strong. So, soil erosion won't happen there where there are many trees. Okay. If you see, if there is an open land, there are grass grown on the that open land. Okay. If you do more and more of gazing of the animals over there, the animals, what they do, they eat all grass and what is left, again the soil. Due to the wind, again it is being blown away. So, we have to stop, reduce the overgrazing of the animals also. So, this is what the soil erosion, if the topmost layer of the soil is being washed away. Did you understand or shall I explain you more clearly, child?
Yes, ma'am. Understood.
Something else in this whole lesson which you have not understood, any of them?
Ma'am,
what happened, child?
Ma'am, I want to ask the question.
Huh, please ask me. Yes, child?
Why upright soil is the side of the river?
Not side of the river, child. It is not always side of the river. See, as I told you, in the formation of the soil, where there are those type of rocks where you find that soil is been there in that particular place. So, everything is dependent on the rocks, child. So, you will not find this soil only near the bank of the rivers. You, if you go to see near any of the river, you will find many other soils also. So, most of the time you will find these type of soil only. But due to the, as I told you, when there are heavy rains or the rivers, water flows away, what happens? The topmost layer is being washed away. So, what you will get? Only the small stones like this. Like this only you will get. So, most probably this type of soil you will find near the rivers. Not all, okay? Near the mountains sometimes. Where there are heavy rains, where there is flow of water, lots of flow of water, you'll find these type of soil because the topmost layer is being washed away. Anything else? Anything else, child, which you have not understood or something? Okay. The notes are not opening, na? I'll send once more today. You just tell me, okay? In the doubt section, you can just question me over there.